Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I am truly honored to be part of this prestigious roundtable discussion on vaccinating South Asia against COVID-19. As we all know, for most part of this year, the world has been engaged in a prolonged battle against the unprecedented challenge of COVID-19 pandemic. While lives have been lost, causing disappointments galore, we must also admire the resilience, hope, and selflessness as shown by people during these testing times. It is also heartening to note that nations have built strong partnerships and are taking collective responsibility to mitigate the risks of this pandemic. The Government of India from day one has followed a proactive, preemptive, graded whole of government and society approach to tackle the pandemic. Despite constraints, effective planning and strategic management has enabled India to keep its cases per million at 7,078 against the global average of 8,883. Similarly, we have worked round the clock to ensure that our fatality rate has remained amongst the lowest in the world at 1.45% as against the global average of 2.27%. Excellencies, India has always been proud of being one of the front runners in the pharmaceutical and vaccine industry. Quoting the humanitarian organization Doctors Without Borders, India is the pharmacy to the developing world. And we take this opportunity with utmost seriousness and integrity. India's world-class research institutes have spearheaded the campaign against COVID-19 and are currently working towards facilitating capacity building for producing, distributing, and administering the vaccine. As I speak here, 260 vaccine candidates are in different stages of development globally. Out of these, 8 are scheduled to be manufactured in India, including 3 indigenous ones. We have enthusiastically leveraged the support of international partners like Oxford University, United Kingdom, and the Thomas Jefferson University, USA, for vaccine research with Indian entities, both public and private. Our Honorable Prime Minister has been supervising the vaccine production efforts personally. He recently visited manufacturing facilities of pharmaceutical companies engaged in production of vaccines, encouraging the scientists at helm and catalyzing the processes. It is expected that the vaccine will be available in the coming few weeks and the vaccination process will kick start in India as soon as it is approved by the concerned regulatory agency. With stringent oversight, we are ensuring that there is no compromise on scientific and regulatory norms stretching from safety of the trials to efficacy of the vaccines. While we are focused on developing a vaccine, we are simultaneously working towards leveraging our efficient and vast vaccine distribution network. We have analyzed our present requirement and are working towards augmenting our capacities, healthcare infrastructure, and workforce. Leveraging the existing digital interventions in our immunization programs, India is working at breathtaking speed for building an advanced digital platform called COVIN, which inter alia will allow citizens to self-register for vaccination, monitor their status, and be provided with a QR code-based electronic vaccination certificate. Before concluding my speech, I would like to take a moment to honor the courage and sacrifice of numerous corona warriors across the globe who have been at the forefront in our fight against COVID-19. I hope, as a fitting tribute to many of them who lost their lives while serving society, we will work with greater zeal and enthusiasm towards building more resilient healthcare systems and achieving the common goal of health for all. I thank you all for giving me the opportunity to address this esteemed gathering.